You want to improve the sense of atmosphere and mood in your work, but you just keep ending up with the same stiff, boring drawings. Today, I have an exercise for you that will only take about 5 minutes and is going to have a huge impact on this aspect of your work. If you're like me, you might already feel like you don't spend enough time on your finished drawings and paintings. So it can be really difficult to justify spending time on doing an exercise. But if you follow along with me and you do this exercise, especially if you do it regularly, you're gonna find your work grows by leaps. And this is the kind of studying that if you neglect it, it's going to hinder your progress. You're gonna get stuck and your work's gonna kind of plateau. At the end of this video, I'm gonna share with you the next steps to take into your long form drawing. So stick with me for that. So this is an exercise you can do in just 5 minutes, and you can do it really from any kind of a situation. You can do it because you've set something up to draw, which is what I'm doing today. I'm gonna draw this little statue. You can do it in a life drawing session. You can do it while you're on the bus and you're looking at people that are sitting in their seats waiting for their stop. You can do it from a photograph. You can do it from a photograph that you have on your phone. Just really convenient. In a sketchbook, at an easel, on your lap, whatever you have. I'm gonna be doing my study today in charcoal on toned paper, so I have black and white charcoal, but again, you could use anything. You could use pen and ink, you could use markers, you could use colored pencils, you could use paint, you could use graphite, whatever you have with you, whatever you have available, you can do this exercise. Do me a favor, and if you enjoy this content, hit like, hit subscribe, and if you want to get serious about taking your figure drawings to the next level, check out my online Figure Drawing Academy. All right, let's get to it. So we've probably all heard of thumbnail sketches, and usually it's in the context of composition. Most of the time, I've employed these miniature sketches with outlines and shapes in order to figure out the optimal placement of objects on a paper or canvas. But recently, I started using these thumbnails for something else entirely. What I want you to do when you begin this thumbnail is to first lightly sketch out a box to work in that is no more than 3 inches on each side. Keep it small, that's the idea. Small little sketch, not too long, not too much detail. And then, without any concern for proportion, and I'm going to repeat that because it's really important, without any concern for proportion, sketch some very basic shapes of your subject. The reason that I don't want you to focus on proportion is that it's way too easy to get hung up on that, and it'll take your focus away from the whole point of this exercise. The point of this exercise is not proportion, it's mood, atmosphere, and edges. So keep your focus there. Just make some shapes that are kind of sort of like your subject, leave out all the details, and you're gonna be ready to go. What I want you to do next, once you have your shapes, is to find the darkest areas and shade them in very dark and even. We want to kind of get lost in that area and have no detail. If you're working on toned paper like I am, find your lightest area and shade that in bright white. If you're not working on toned paper and you're working on white paper, then find the lightest area, leave it blank, and shade everything else a medium tone. So now what you're gonna have is a little sketch with really dark, medium, and light values. This is where the magic comes in. There are two things that I want you to very purposefully look for. These are not things that are just gonna jump out at you. You need to on purpose observe them. The first thing is a large gradient across an entire form or area. So what I mean by this is that sometimes just because something is getting further away from the light source, it might get a little darker. So things closer to the light source are lighter, things further are darker. Or sometimes distance causes a value to change. Something could be really dark up close and then lighter in the distance. Something could be really light and intense up close and then a little darker or grayer in the distance. For whatever reason that transition is happening, I want you to look for it, find it, and then exaggerate it. I don't want you to stick with just what you feel like you're able to actually observe. Really push that, and that is going to start to emphasize the atmosphere and the mood. The second thing that I want you to do is to absolutely hunt for lost edges. Again, lost edges are not something that are going to just jump out at you. You're going to go looking for the edges, and as you move your eyes around and your eyes adjust, you're going to find those edges. So ironically, lost edges are quite difficult to find. This is because that when we look at the lost edge, instantly our eyes adjust and we see it. So the trick here is to purposefully look for where the edge could be lost. What I want you to do is look at the lightest area in your subject or your reference photo or whatever it is. Then I want you to let your eyes go just a little bit out of focus so that everything looks funny. And without moving where you're looking, keep looking at that light area. Notice in your peripheral vision where you can't really see edges, where you feel like you want to move your eyes so that you can find where the edge is. This is that magic place where you can have lost edges. Often this is in the shadow, things are dark, so things aren't being defined, but this also happens in the light areas too. So train yourself to look at the lightest area, let your eyes go out of focus, and see where some edges aren't standing out and let those get lost. Completely lose the edge, don't even hint at where it is, and I promise you, your mind is going to fill it in and it's going to draw your attention to the important areas where there really are contrasts to define. Notice how much these two things, the large gradient across an entire form and lost edges, create atmosphere, mood, and presence in these little thumbnails. Keep in mind, this is something that you can do as a standalone practice just while you're waiting on the phone with the IRS, you have time to doodle, or because you want to intentionally study these effects on their own outside of doing any other work. But you can also do these as parts of your larger works. When you have a drawing or a painting that you're working on for a long time, take 5 minutes and do one of these thumbnails and push those edges and those gradients over the entire form, because it's really impossible when you are just on autopilot and you're doing your thing for hours on end, like drawing or painting or whatever, you lose sight of these things. You have to really purposefully and very consciously train yourself to observe and implement these things. So see how it can be an exercise, and also see how it can work into your bigger images. Now that you've completed this exercise and you're ready to utilize these ideas in a long form drawing, check out my video over here of my flexible life drawing method. See you there.